there's any preference there. Figured I would try switching it up for today. But without further ado, we're gonna open up our trusty notebook and flip to a blank page. Thursday night game. Which was the Commanders versus the Bears. As I predicted, this game was terrible. The Thursday night game, once again, let everybody down. This game finished 12-7. Of the Commanders. If I remember correctly, the week before, the Thursday night game was 12-9 Colts Broncos. I did not watch this game. I assumed it was going to be awful again, and I was proven correct. So glad I didn't watch this. Carson Wentz got injured in this one and will be out for a few weeks. So an already pretty mediocre Commanders team will be a little worse in the coming weeks. Both teams are now 2-4 after this game. We had Justin Fields leading the game in passing with 190 yards and a touchdown. He also led the game in rushing with 88 yards on the ground. And Dante Pettis of the Bears led the game in receiving with 84 yards and a touchdown. I'm not sure what the Thursday night game is going to be this week, but hopefully it's better than this one and the one before that. I haven't looked at the schedule yet. I'll be doing my predictions video tomorrow, so be on the lookout for that. Next up, we have the Patriots versus the Browns. Big win for my Patriots in this one. Winning 38-15 on the road. The Patriots are now 3-3, and the Browns are 2-4. Patriots rookie Bailey Zappe threw for 309 yards and 2 touchdowns. He's looked very good in his first 2 games. Ramondre Stevenson led the game with 76 yards and 2 touchdowns. And Donovan Peoples-Jones of the Browns had 74 yards receiving to lead the game. Yeah, Bailey Zappe has proved himself to be a pretty formidable backup to Mac Jones for whenever Mac comes back to action. But as a Patriots fan, I would not be disappointed to see that either of them are starting a game at quarterback at this point. Next up, we Buccaneers versus the Falcons. The Falcons won this one. 28-14. Both teams are now 3-3. Pretty surprising from the Falcons. I think a lot of people expected them to probably come in dead last this year, or maybe second to last. But a 3-3 start for them is pretty good. And they beat a pretty good 49ers team by 2 touchdowns. Jimmy Garoppolo had 296 yards passing and 2 touchdowns. Caleb Huntley led the game with 59 yards rushing. And Brandon Ayuk had 83 yards and 2 touchdowns to lead the game in receiving. Next up is another kind of surprise team. The Jets versus the Packers. In Green Bay, the Jets won this one. 27-10, which was again a bit of a surprise. The Jets are now 4-2, and the Packers are 3-3. Aaron Rodgers led the game with 246 yards and a touchdown. Hall had 20 carries for 116 yards and a touchdown, and he looks like he could be the next superstar running back in the league. And Robert Tonyan had 10 catches for 90 yards to lead the game in receiving. But yeah, the Jets look like they're a pretty solid squad so far at this point in the year. Did not expect that from them. I think they were maybe 7-point underdogs in that game and wound up winning by 17. Next game was Colts versus Jaguars. The Colts won this game. 34-27. They won this game pretty late. I think it was tied with maybe less than a minute to go. And they ended up scoring a touchdown to take the lead. The Colts improved to 3-2-1. The Jaguars are now 2-4. Matt Ryan completed 42 passes, which I believe is the most completed passes in a game for any Colts quarterback, even more so than Peyton Manning. 42 passes for 389 yards and 3 touchdowns. Travis Etienne led the game with 86 yards rushing. And Michael Pittman Jr. had 13 catches for 134 yards. Next game was the Vikings versus Dolphins. The Vikings won 24-16. The Vikings are now 5-1, and the Dolphins are 3-3. Surprisingly, Skylar Thompson, the Dolphins' third string, started this game, but then he got hurt, so Teddy Bridgewater came in. I thought Bridgewater would have and to give the rookie a shot. So Bridgewater played and led the game in passing with 329 yards and 2 touchdowns. Dalvin Cook had 77 yards and a touchdown. And Tyreek Hill led the game with 12 catches and 177 yards. Tua Tagovailoa is expected to be back for the Week 7 game. So this upcoming week, Tua is supposed to be back. So the Dolphins should see a bit of an uptick in form. They've lost a couple games in a row without Tua, and he should be back. Next up is Bengals versus Saints. Pretty high scoring game here with the Bengals winning 30-26. Chase had 132 yards and 2 touchdowns on 7 receptions. The Bengals are now 3-3, and the Saints are 2-4. Next up is what I think is, well, next two games were the surprises of the week for me. First was Ravens-Giants, with the Giants winning 24-20. I did not think the Giants were actually a good team. I thought they were frauds. But they are now 5-1, and the Ravens are 3-3. I need to start giving the Giants a bit more respect after this game. I think in my predictions videos, I think I might have said they were going to lose by 10 points or so. But they just seem to keep on winning. Brian Daboll has established a winning culture over there in New York, and he keeps getting results. So Lamar Jackson had 210 yards and a touchdown. Kenyon Drake led the game with 119 yards and a touchdown on 10 carries. And Mark Andrews had 106 yards and a touchdown on 7 catches to lead the game in receiving. Interesting how all the stat leaders were Ravens, yet they lost the game. And this is probably the surprise of the week. The Bucks versus the Steelers. The Steelers beat the Bucks 20-18. I believe the Bucks were like 8.5-point favorites in this one. And they lost to a mixture of Kenny Pickett and Mitch Trubisky at quarterback. The Steelers are now 2-4, and the Bucks are 3-3. One thing about this year I've noticed so far, at least, is that there's not really any dominant teams. Yes, the Eagles, we'll get to this in a bit, the Eagles are undefeated still. And the Bills and Chiefs are good. But it seems like for the most part, anybody can beat anybody on a given Sunday. And I feel like we haven't had that in a few years. There's a lot of teams that are 3-3, 2-4, 4-5. average kind of within one game of everybody. So that's pretty cool to see again. Tom Brady led this game with 243 yards and a touchdown. Leonard Fournette had 63 yards to lead the game in rushing. And Chase Claypool had 96 yards and a touchdown receiving. Next up is Rams-Panthers. The Rams won 24-10. Definitely a needed win for the Rams as they are now 3-3. Are 1-5. Matt Stafford had 253 yards and a touchdown. Christian McCaffrey had 69 yards rushing and also led the game with 89 yards receiving. And I think, just based off the top of my head, going over the recap videos that I've done in the past, this is the first game Cooper Kupp hasn't led the game in receiving. At least that's what it seems like. Next up is Seahawks Cardinals. The Seahawks won 19-9. Had 7 catches for 70 yards. The Seahawks are now 3-3, and the Cardinals are 2-4. Next up was the big one. The Bills versus the Chiefs. The Bills won this one 24-20. Last year. A little surprise, this one wasn't higher scoring, it was more of a defensive battle for most of it. Still a good game though. I think I picked the Bills to win this one, so not too surprised with that result either. Good game. I imagine they're gonna probably meet in the AFC Championship game this year, if I had to pick. The Bills are now 5-1, and the Chiefs are 4-2. Sunday night game, we had Cowboys-Eagles. Eagles won 26-17. As I mentioned earlier, they remain undefeated and are now 6-0. The only undefeated team left. And the Cowboys are 4-2. Cooper Rush suffers his first loss as a starting quarterback. But he did lead the game in passing with 181 yards and a touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott had 81 yards and a touchdown. And CeeDee Lamb had 68 yards receiving to lead the game. It'll be interesting to see how far last night. Which was the Broncos versus the Chargers. The Chargers won 19-16 in overtime. And I just highlighted the wrong team. Whoops. I did that in my Premier League video yesterday too. I'm not sure what's going on. Chargers win in overtime. That's two overtime losses in a row for the Broncos, who are now 2-4, and the Chargers are 4-2. Justin Herbert led the game with 238 yards and an interception. Something interesting, just a fun little note about him. There was a DraftKings Super Boost where I believe it was Justin Herbert was -800 odds to throw one touchdown in this game. And they made it even odds, so if you bet $10, you win $10. And he had thrown a touchdown in 36 out of 37 of his career starts. And right when they boost it all the way up to even odds, he does not throw a touchdown pass for only the second time in his career. Pretty interesting. Fishy or a coincidence? I'll leave that up to you. Latavius Murray had 66 yards rushing. And Josh Palmer led the game in receiving with 9 catches and 57 yards. The teams on a bye were the Lions, Raiders, Titans, and Texans. We're all on a bye this week. And that is all of the games that happened in week 6 of the NFL. As I said earlier, I will be doing week 7 predictions soon, and they'll be coming out either Wednesday or Thursday.